include Shaar Yichud VeEmunah, the second book, the book that is the gateway, the pathway to the unity, the oneness of God, and the true faith that what we really believe in, that oneness of God. We spoke about a unity that comes from above, and now it's a unity that comes from within, from below. A lower level unity. Lower doesn't mean it's lesser. It just means it's a different perspective. So by way of illustration of what it means lower, lower means in the form of light. So there's rays of light that come from the sun. So that's one radiation. But then when it hits the moon and the light that comes from there, that's called a radiation of a radiation. And of course, it's a lesser light. It's not as strong. It's not as powerful. It's only a reflection of the sun's light. So the sun's light is a radiation itself, because it's not the sun, it's a radiation of the light. And then it's reflecting off the moon, that's radiation of a radiation. What does that mean? That's a metaphor for us to understand that the letters of God's utterance that he creates with those letters, those words, that a life force with God's words create something from nothing, right? That in those words, in those letters, is the divine emotions. As we have spoken about, human being only speaks that which they have a feeling towards. The stronger the feeling, the more you're going to talk about that, right? So invested in the divine word that God animates creation is a divine emotion, which those divine emotions are one with God himself. So what we have over here is it's a derivative of a derivative, a light of a light, right? The metaphor that we're using. And that just shows on the come down on the power of that light. That the original light that animates is the 10 sayings, the 10 pronouncements that are in the book of Genesis that God creates. Let there be light, let there be a firmament, a heaven above that's between the waters, the spiritual waters above and the physical waters below, and the like, right? All of those are a derivative. They are the word. But then from those comes a derivative of a derivative, meaning you take letters, as we've explained many times, right? You take from the original letters. Again, this is all an allegory, a metaphor for us to understand the power of creator within creation and how creation comes about, how we have multiplicity. Is because now you're taking a composition, you're taking a substitution. You're taking a letter here and a letter there, making a new word. Aleph, Shin makes Aish, fire. And then sometimes what you do is transpose, you make a transposition of words, of letters rather, right? You're taking a letter from here and you're changing it from the Aleph to the Taf or the Aleph to the Vav, whatever. All of that is only to bring out that there it's a derivative of a derivative, and actually it's even another level, another derivative. A light of a light of a light. What does that only show? On the contraction of the divine light as it comes down. And the whole point of this is the more it comes down, that means the more there's multiplicity. The more there is more types of creation, because you have more words that you can make up. For those who know, you know, word puzzles and so on, how many words, you know, my wife does, what's the new York Times thing? I forgot what it's called. She's pretty good at it. She gets it now all the time. So what is that? How many combinations can there be here? Well, New York Times puzzle, It's limited. But in God's creation, it's unlimited. Because even though you're starting with the original letters of Genesis, but you don't have all creation there. And you only have part of creation. So as you take letters and combine the combinations of letters, substitutions of letters, and now you even have the numeric value of letters. All that shows that a come down on the divine light that now is creating new life-giving letters that give new creation to a new being, a new species of animals, a new type of flower, and so on and so forth. All of this is that it brings down to even inanimate stones and earth that are created from a light of a light of a light, a derivative, a derivative, of a derivative, the lowest level, because that's lifeless. But it's all lifeless because it's being animated by the word of God in this fashion that we just spoke about. Substitution of substitutions, transpositions of transpositions. And with that, Nishlam Chelik Sheni B'ezras Hashem Yisborach Yisaleh, we have concluded the second part. With the help of God, may be blessed and exalted. So what have we over here? In what do we have here is showing how there's such diversity, but that diversity is creating ad infinitum different types of creations, spiritual creations, physical creations in this world. Wordle, thank you. Creating different kinds of creations in this world. What is it all, though? The word of God that's animating. And all of different types of derivatives of that word of God. Different forms of how that takes place. And it's that word of God that's animating it in a unique manner that makes it what it is. This animal, an Ari, the letters Aleph, Resh, Yud, is its vital force. And so on and so forth. A Shoshana is a rose, or Vered is a rose, maybe. In any case, the point being, it's that these letters, but they're not the original letters, they're combinations, substitutions of substitutions, and so on and so forth, in order that it just shows allegorically on the come down of the light, that it is a lesser light, meaning it creates a lesser creation. And that lesser creation just means the light of God is more hidden, as in a stone, as in the earth. But it is the utterance of God that's animating it. And what's vested in that utterance of God is divine emotion. Chesed words veretz netzachot yisoid malchus, as we explained earlier at great length, right? As we've mentioned, you only speak that which you have an emotional feeling towards. Invested in that divine emotion, of course, is the divine wisdom, and in that is the Ein Sof, God Himself. God that is beyond any definition. Vested in that. But it's all vested, meaning that's not what is the direct force that is perceivable. I don't know if perceivable is a right word, but is directly responsible, is the word of God. And that word of God animates something from nothing every single moment. And therefore, we are not separate from God. We are totally bound up and one with Him in a unity that we can appreciate the diversity. And in that diversity, what is the reality of it? God that's animating and bringing into creation, you and I. Powerful. And when we think about that, We should go around and perceive a world around us and a diversity and appreciate the diversity. But what is a diversity? Nothing else but the oneness of God. How? By the derivative of derivative, derivative of the letters and so on. Now, we don't know those letters. I don't know them, at least. You know, Kabbalah, you can know more about that, but that's what's not important. It's just to appreciate and meditate and think. Let's do that for a moment. How I'm being animated myself right now by the Word of God. Breathe in, breathe out. And with every breath, new life comes with that breath. And then we exhale that new life in order to get new life once again. With every breath, God is animating us with His Word, me uniquely. Each and every one of us uniquely. All of creation is also vibrating, is also alive, even a stone, even a rock that seems inanimate, but it is vibrant. The Word of God that's animating it, it's alive. It's so alive that when Mashiach will come, when we will step on a rock and be kind of mindless, the rock will be alive. It will talk to us and say to us, Bullock, or a bloch, what are you stepping on me? You think you're greater than me? If our minds are empty, we're not greater. We're lesser. We're lesser. So, yeah, can a donkey talk? This week's parsha? Yes. Can a stone talk? Absolutely. How could it? Well, because God talks to it to bring it into being so it exists. Now, does it talk in a language that we're speaking right now? That we can, not in, you know, I'm not going to speak with a French accent or an English accent, right? But it's vibrating with vitality. And when we meditate and think about that, that I am, and the food that I'm eating is, and the food that I'm eating is the Word of God that animates it, and it's, that's what makes it valuable. That kosher food for a Jew that is being animated, and that's what's giving me vitality. Not the palate that seeks, or the eye that seeks, you know, the pleasure. That's our meditation. There's a lot there and a lot more, which we will have tonight, in, by the way, in TRC, Tiny Rabbi Community, which we have Sunday nights. Powerful stuff, and that's a conclusion.